Hello everyone. So today I will be sharing solutions from the recently concluded Pure Math 1, A-Level Pure Math 1 paper variant 3, May-June 2025. I have received some requests for me to share the solution for the progression question. That's what I was told. And so I looked into it, and that would be question 6. So question 6 is a question on arithmetic progression. So let's just go through the question and the solutions, right? So let's read through the question. An arithmetic progression has the first term A and a common difference 2. The nth term is 55 and the sum of the first three n terms is 5760. Find the values of n and A. Now what you should notice first is that they are asking for 2. Two different values for two, sorry, they are asking for the values of two different unknowns, okay? So two different unknowns, and also they provide you with two different sets of information, which means that you can set up two different equations and then solve for two different unknowns, which sounds like simultaneous equations. So that should be something that clicks very quickly with you when you go through the question here. Right, you should notice that immediately so that you can immediately start to strategize on how to solve this question. So, best thing to do, list out the stuff that we already know and then start making the equations. So, we already know that the common difference, by the way, it's an arithmetic progression. So, the common difference is 2. So, we're going to use the formula for the nth term of an arithmetic progression. And we will substitute d equals 2 in that formula, and since we know it's equal to 55, so we set this as an equation. So this is an equation with two unknowns. We can simplify it, right, and it becomes a plus 2n equals 57. And then you can make a the subject. So if you make a the subject, it will look like this, right? A equals 57 minus 2n. So we're going to use that later with the other equation that we're going to set up, so that we can then solve for the values of n and then the value of a. Right, so second equation will relate to the fact that the sum of the first three n terms in this arithmetic progression is 5760. So we set it up, right? The formula is all available in the MF ranking. Just apply the appropriate values, right? Replace our n with 3n here, replace the d with 2, and set it to be equal to 5760. Now, of course, it's better to simplify this, right? So we can multiply by 2. Divide by 3, divide by 2, and you'll get this equation, right? So right now, we can then expand this, right? N times a plus 3n minus 1 here. So if you expand, you'll get this. And notice that here, I kept the a minus 1 together so that I can write it in this format, which is very recognizable, right? This is a quadratic equation. But the problem is right now, we have both n and a in this equation. So the best thing to do is to make this into a single unknown equation, or single variable equation. So we'll use the first equation that we had before, right? And we do the substitution. Now notice that this is a minus 1 and this is a. So if a is 57 minus 2n, then a minus 1 would be 56 minus 2n. So that's what's going to replace a minus 1 there. All right, and then we can expand again and simplify. And we should get a quadratic equation like this. And at this point, right, it's up to you. You want to choose whatever method you want to help you solve this quadratic equation, whether it's a shortcut or a long way, whatever it is that you want to do, right? So, you can use factorization. This is indeed factorizable, actually. You can use factorization. You can use completing the squares. You can use the quadratic formula, or you can use the calculator even, right? Some of you might have a calculator that can actually solve quadratic equations, so that could be an option as well. So if you do it correctly, without any mistake, right, you'll get n equals 24 and n equals negative 80. Now, we should look at what n represents here. N represents sort of like the enter basically n has to be a counting number, right? It has to be a positive integer. So out of these two, only 24 is a positive integer, and negative 80 is a negative integer. So we will reject this solution. So our only possible answer for n is 24, right? And then we will use this and substitute into 57 minus 2n, and we'll get 57 minus 48. Okay. After that, we'll get a to be equals to 9. So a equals 9 and n equals 24. We have found the values of m and a. Mission accomplished. All right. And then, before we end here, I would like to talk about the marks distribution here. This is a 6-mark question. So technically, you should try and do this question in 6 minutes. In terms of how the marking is distributed, I would imagine that just listing the two equations by applying the formulas, right, for the nth term and also the sum of the first n terms, those would usually be a B1 mark. M1 marks for performing the simultaneous equations, I would imagine you get actually 2 M1 marks there. Writing this quadratic, right, getting down to this quadratic is also another M1. And then final answer, each one is an A1. So I would say in total there will be 6 marks, at least 1 B1 mark, maybe 3 M1 marks, and then, 1 B1 mark, 3 M1 marks, and then 2 A1 marks, right, for the end. Right, if you understand the terminology for the marking schemes, in terms of what is a B1, what is an M1, and what is an A1. Okay, so after all of that working, right, if you get A equals 9 and N equals 24, then you are right, and you have done a very good job.